Welcome to another episode of the Turf and Tools podcast. This is the 8th annual, correct?
7th? 8th?
No, this
seven,
is the 8th. Keep talking,
Karthik. Okay then. What are you bringing over? There you go, the feature product.
Yeah, this is what we're going to be talking about this episode very shortly. It's the Ego. It's the new multi-tool from Ego. It's not a commercial unit. They do have a commercial unit coming out next year, I believe. Not 100% sure, but this is the domestic unit. We will be talking about that shortly. Also doing the giveaway.
That's
the two copies
right.
of Lawn Mowing Simulator and the Milwaukee electronic pruners. So we'll do that very shortly. What have you been up to?
Not much. Still in training. I've got one more week to go. So hopefully next weekend I'll be a free man again from training.
Well, I can't wait for that.
Yeah.
We might actually be able to get out and try some of these tools at the same time.
Well, I'm still available in the evenings, but you've had a busy few weeks there, house hunting and stuff like that.
Yes.
What's been up with you?
House hunting. I'm over it already, severely over it. I'm probably at that point where I'm just going to buy something that I'll regret. But no, we've been looking at different sorts of properties now, like larger blocks of land and having aspirations to have veggie gardens and, you know,
hobby farms.
Well, not so much hobby farm, more just veggie gardens and beautiful gardens.
Yeah, no, why not? Why not? If you've got some bushland in the back of it as well, that always adds a nice little touch.
I don't know, it's just, every house I've lived in has been a new house, so.
And always suburban, I presume?
Yeah.
Yeah, there you go.
So
yeah.
I've just got this desire now to be out amongst the trees and nature.
You're getting old, mate. Getting
old. I know, I am. We were watching, Nicole and I watched like 3 episodes of Gardening Australia last night.
Yeah. didn't someone call us out on the last episode as well to say we were... I think I saw you post a story with that comment as well on Tim the Lawnmower Man.
Oh, yeah. I don't think they were actually having a
I'm not sure. I think he might have been being funny, but given the lack of the laughing emoji, he might very well have been having a go.
Yeah, the comment was something along the lines of once you get 40 plus or whatever and the intimacy goes in your relationship, you start spending more time on
the lawn.
But yeah, like I don't think it was meant to be really having a go at it.
I don't think so either. I think it was just a sense of humor, which we got, I said. Yeah. It's just because there's nothing there to imply he was just taking the piss. You kind of go, are you taking the mickey? Yeah, but anyway.
So yeah, I got mad aspirations for beautiful garden beds and then different sections of turf. Like I'm thinking plant a tree, garden bed underneath it, then different, like maybe circular lawn areas with different types of lawn. And I don't know, this is just like the dream, whether it happens or not.
Yeah.
And a big shed, ideally. That would be nice.
That'd be suitable as well. Yeah.
I mean, obviously I need space. I have space here at Store Hub. We're at Store Hub again, obviously. But yeah, I still need more space.
Mm-hmm. Never ends, does it?
We looked at one today that had a mega, like, American barn style shed. 10 by 10 shed, and then it had a pad of concrete that was, like, including the shed, was probably 300 square meters of concrete, which is 2/3 of my whole property currently.
Currently, yeah.
Just in the concrete and the shed. And I'm like, wow.
Yeah, you buy that, you got to then go buy a boat as well so you can actually fill the space, isn't it?
Yeah.
A camper van.
I'm not into
You're not a camping guy?
Things. No. Okay,
there you go.
No. Maybe I will at some point, but it's... I like the idea of camping, but I think the reality of it... I'm a little bit particular about getting the bottoms of my feet dirty and traipsing in.
Oh, God, okay.
Yeah, I'm a little bit precious.
I'm definitely the other end, other extreme, I think, in terms of camping.
You're not a camper, are you?
Oh, we love it. We absolutely love it.
Where have you been camping?
We're definitely not equipped for it.
Yeah.
But, so we stay local, obviously.
Where do you go?
We've done the one at, let me try and think, I think it was North Narrabeen. There's a campsite that's really good because it's just across from the beach. It's a powered site, so...
That would be Narrabeen.
This was when I still had the ute, so that made it a bit easier as well because we could stick everything we needed.
You went full Aussie mode.
We've done a couple...
You got a dual cab ute and you're like, we've got to go camping.
Yeah. No. And the funny thing was my daughter actually picked it because it was her birthday and she had a few options, obviously. So it was like birthday party with her friends and there was a couple other things and one of the options was camping as well. And because we'd done a couple of little ones prior to that...
Yeah.
She went, I'll go camping as long as it's like sort of longer than 2 nights, I think. So we said, yeah, okay, that's even better. So we
She said she's determining how long you're going.
No, no, no. She said like she would have the kids' birthday party normally, but she said if it's camping and it's more than just a one night stay.
So she's really negotiating hard.
Yeah. And she went, if it's two nights and more, then yeah, I'll take camping over the birthday party. So we said, yeah, okay, you got what you wanted.
In a tent?
Yeah, we've got everything else. We've got the tent. We've got, like, if we need it, we've got a stove and stuff like that. We don't have a ute, unfortunately, anymore.
How was the weather?
Rained on the way there, but then cleared out and we had
Have you had a camping experience where it has been...
No, we've lucked out with the weather. We've been fine. I mean, we have researched it prior to as well. Yeah. And it's not like we've gone for, like, a week-long one. Yeah. So it's usually been, like I said, a night or two nights at the most. So we've checked weather before making plans. So yeah, it's worked out for us.
I think the last time I went camping, I would have been 17. One of my mates had got their license. So he had a single cab Hilux ute.
Yeah.
And we're like, let's go camping. And we went to, where did we go? Uminer or something? I can't remember. Mm-hmm. Somewhere.
Not a fan after that, is it?
Well, we just went to a campsite. It even wasn't directly on the beach or whatever. All we had was a tent. It was the middle of summer. And we were excited driving up there, listening to music on the way up, all lamped. And then it was just like 40 degree weather and there was nowhere to escape the sun.
Oh, no. Okay.
At this park.
That's not good. No, we're fully set up for the beach as well. So we've got that, you know, the popular cabana things that came into trend. Yeah. So we got one of those. And I know when my missus bought that and like one of those beach buggies, and I was kind of like, oh, that's just so soft. We don't need it. But God, am I glad
we've got it. You have the beach buggy, the pull along thing.
Yeah. Mate, between that buggy and that... cabana, it doesn't really matter how hot it gets. If you're at the beach especially, I did not used to like the beach. I like mountains and rivers and staying in the shade.
That's
and stuff
like
that. But once since we got that, it's not that I don't like the mountains and river anymore, but beaches have become a lot more fun for me.
Because,
as long as you've got an esky with some beers as well, mate, you're set.
Yeah. No, I don't like the beach. I don't like camping. I'm really a bit of a wet blanket. Not fun at all.
You probably would struggle with the staying stationary, just sitting there, not doing anything.
Yeah, I'm not good at holidays. I don't know what to do.
Yeah. I can see that already.
But then at the same time, I get overstimulated when I do go and do stuff and then I just get frustrated. And I like breakfast. I like breakfast, nice breakfast, going out for breakfast and then... a couple of hours later thinking about what am I going
to do. Yeah, you need activities to keep you occupied.
It's food.
Yeah.
I just like eating. Having someone just arrive at Store Hub right now, keying in their PIN to get the gate open, and they're going to drive in and see two guys set up in a podcast, which is always odd. We might do the giveaway while we're doing that. The gate almost took out the camera. We'll give away the two copies of Lawn Mowing Simulator for Switch first. If you are... I really need to think these giveaways out a bit more how people let me know who they are. Send me an email, timthelawnmowerman@gmail.com, if you are one of the winners. We've got a random comment generator. You've got a pretty high chance of winning if you are. There's 289 comments total. You did have to comment Milwaukee. So we're going to try and draw the first one. Karthik is the certified official for this one.
Oh, my God.
First winner is...
Kiris Vlog 9495. I think that's how you say it.
Yeah, Kiris Vlog 9495. I'll put it up on the screen anyway. Kiris Vlog, KirisVlogs 9495. Thank you for taking a picture of that, Karthik, because I would have forgotten. Mm-hmm. So that's the first winner. You've won a copy of Lawn Mowing Simulator for Switch. I hope you have a Switch. Because it's pretty useless to you otherwise.
They can stick it back on Marketplace.
Yeah, I did fire it up the other day. Had a quick burn of it. I found it harder to operate the ride-on mower in the game than I do in real life, which is surprising.
I had people at work talking about it, but they were talking about it like, oh, have you guys seen this silly game? And I kind of went, hey, that's pretty popular there. But we've got a couple of extra subscribers from work now because of that
conversation. There you go.
Yeah.
Well, our next winner is, drawing it now, another copy of Lawn Mowing Simulator 4 Switch.
We got at ECP4500.
Yeah, so these are on YouTube. That was how you entered, commenting on the YouTube video of podcast number 6. So ECP4500, You and Carice, I think, have won copies of Lawn Mowing Simulator for Switch. The big prize, though, I can't even hold it here because it's at home. The Milwaukee Electric Pruners. Now, it is a skin only. It's not a kit, but still, that's a pretty good get.
Nah, it was a good bit of kit.
All right, I'm going to press pick another winner for that. Here we go. Hopefully, they comment Milwaukee. The first two did comment Milwaukee, just to be clear.
Mm-hmm.
Where's the comment? Milwaukee. These clippers might just be the trick to keep my tiger grass hedge under control. Great show, guys. Thank you very much. That is all my mojo.
All my mojo.
My mojo. Congratulations, you've won the Milwaukee electronic pruners. Hopefully we can do another giveaway at some point. Maybe when we get to podcast 100 or something.
100?
Give away a mower or something. It's not that far away, really, is it?
Yeah, no, once a week. It's 2 years. That's not that far, you're right.
Yeah. I've had some more gear arrive during the week. A lot, actually. I've been flat out and haven't had a chance to test anything. So it's been, boxes have been arriving.
So you've still been doing the, did you get a free mower Friday in?
Yes. I did the front yard of that mammoth backyard that I did. Well, when I say mammoth, it was a reasonably small backyard, but quite high. Had the farmer's friends plants.
Okay.
The backyard, you know?
I remember.
I had it stuck all over me. God. I'd never seen so many in my life. It was basically a backyard full
Why
of
that. Why is that thing called farmer's friend?
There's quite a few names for it.
Okay.
So some people will know what I'm talking about. Other people will call it something else. But cool. I don't know why they're called farmer's friends. But, yeah, did the front yard there, which wasn't crazy, but lots of satisfying edges and everything to do.
Reveals.
Yeah. I used the Makita mower.
Yep, battery one,
I took that out a couple of times this week. Made a video. I don't know if you saw it.
How's it go with the swing back blades instead of the...
Yeah, it's got swing back blades. Yeah. So different to most electric lawnmowers. Which generally just come straight from the States or whatever and they're made for that market, come over with a bar blade.
Mm-hmm.
Plus, I think the bar blades must get you better runtime.
I think they must help with how much power it's using up,
Because you just don't see... The only other one we've seen with the swing back blades was the Massport 60 volt, but they had two swing back blades.
Yeah.
So having four swing back blades, it can't see the difference or anything. It just sort of feels normal to me, but I didn't hit anything, so that's really where they're going to pay off, obviously.
Yeah,
if I do hit a bolt or something, but I would never do something like that.
Never.
I used it on a large Sir Grange lawn.
Okay.
And I don't know, did you see the little video I made of it?
I might have seen the
POV
Grange
video.
It was starting to
striped up. So I filmed it on the Ray-Ban glasses and that makes the colours a little bit weird.
Right,
it had lost a little bit of colour, the Grange, but in person it looked really good. And striped up well for just, you know, rotary battery mower.
Okay, there you go. Is it the little rubber flap at the back that stripes it pretty much? Usually that's what is on the mowers, right? Oh, he's running away.
I didn't even notice. Now, you know, it hasn't even got that stripe. No, it's just
catches or something, rubber. Okay.
No, it hasn't even got that rubber flap down the bottom dragging along at the back, but it has got the grooves in the front, you know, the comb, the plastic comb bits.
So that's bending it over.
Yes, so I think that's pushing it over. And anyway, I thought it looked nice. It was nice to use. The biggest compliment I can give that mower is I'm not using it and thinking, oh, I wish it was this or I wish it did this or it just... It works. It seems like a no fuss.
Okay. Does what was asked of it?
Yeah. Like it's different in design. Obviously, I've got the Milwaukee as well, and I really like the layout of the controls. It feels really ergonomic, and this is, you know, pretty basic in the controls. Just the front and rear. You know, you got one bale for the blade.
This is the Makita, yeah.
Yeah. One bale for the blade. One bale for the self-propel.
Mm-hmm.
It just feels no nonsense. It just feels kind of like a commercial tool, if you know what I mean.
Okay,
like it's just there to work.
Cool. Well, what's it exactly called? Just because we called it the Makita mower, but
40. What's the 40 volt 553? I think they call it.
And it takes what? 40 volt batteries, or
It takes two 40 volt batteries, but only needs one to run.
Right. Okay. Yep. So it probably draws one fully before it then flips to the next one.
It does, which I didn't know. I actually asked in my comments. Someone said, yeah, I've had this mower for a while and they liked it. What I was noticing was when the first battery got somewhat, you know, nearly depleted.
Yep.
The voltage drops like most batteries do.
Okay.
And then I'm thinking, oh, do I have to manually switch this over? Because it's just like the RPM drops right down.
Yeah, yeah.
And I'm thinking, am I an idiot? I'm trying to look for a button or I'm holding down the, you know, the quiet mode and trying to get it to work and it still wouldn't work. So, apparently it just... it'll completely deplete it, then switch over. I haven't got to that point because I just got annoyed with it going at low voltage and switched the batteries over.
Okay, and that did the job, did it?
And then it started using the other one. But if you, it will switch over itself, but once it's fully depleted, apparently, which is a bit annoying for me.
Yeah, I was going to say, just at the end there, if it's dropping off and you're waiting around for it to fully deplete, but it's not giving you full performance in the meanwhile.
No, because it's one of the few battery modes I've used that is full noise just when you turn it on. Like the default mode is just high RPM,
which
I love.
Yeah.
It's like, that's what I want. If I want to turn it down, I'll turn it down.
Mm-hmm.
If I want to turn it to, you know, the variable...
eco settings, yeah.
Yeah, if I want to put it on low RPM, like call it quiet mode, I'll do that. If I want to put it on the variable one, I'll do that, but I'll almost never do the variable one.
Yeah, but default, you just want it flat chat.
I want that sort of control over it. So I do like that they've got that. I think because of that, though... your runtime does get quite depleted.
Yep.
I did two passes on that large lawn. That's about a 750 square meter block total, not grass, but just, which is a decent sized block for out here. I did two passes on it. There's a bit of growth in there and Sir Grange, so quite thick as well.
Yeah,
so,
yeah.
And I'd done the cleanup phase of the front yard of that Fremo Fridays and basically depleted to 8 amp hour batteries.
Okay, that's all bad.
Essentially it's 1.5 properties, but double cut, full, what I would say is it's going to be perfect for just about any home user. Mm-hmm. I don't think there's going to be any complaint there. If you're trying to use it commercially, I'd want to have some sort of onboard charging setup on your rig, which I would want to for any battery setup. That's the only way I would run 100% battery stuff, if I had some permanent charging solution. Yeah.
But I think with Makita, there's so many people that are sort of so truly invested in their platform for other tools already. So for them, it's good to know that the Mowa, if they do pick it up, if they've got the batteries already at home, they've got a Mowa that's reliable. And
I think a lot less, obviously, with the XGT batteries. Like, I don't know. Well, I mean, I've got the 18-volt batteries at home for my stuff, had them for years, and I know, plenty of people do.
Yeah, but not necessarily the 40-volt.
Yeah, it hasn't been out as long, and then it's a more higher-end
product
system. But I like the mower.
Okay, you know? Good.
I feel like I need to make a video, because I made that video and I was pointing out, this is what I like about it, and I did say that the chute clogged a couple of times out the back, because there was quite a bit of length out there, and as I said, the Grange can be quite dense. But I think I need to make a companion video that, please refer to this video for limitations around battery mowers, because it doesn't matter what I put out. It's like I'm just telling you my thoughts on the mower. I feel like I have to qualify it with, if it's running at full RPM in under load, battery time's going to be right down.
We had a really quick sort of chat on messages on those new POV videos you've got.
Yeah.
You're putting out. I think that might be one of the ways as well, because as you're doing the work, if you've got that on, it might be a way where you're just talking out loud what you just said you were thinking the whole time.
Well, I did that, but what I mean, I don't want to include in every video the limitations for battery mowers.
It'd be like in
every petrol mower video saying, oh, this thing's quite loud, or you need to carry fuel.
Yeah, it's great, but it's burning fossil fuels or whatever.
Oh, you need to get it served. You just don't do that. It's like, I feel for most people anyway, well, maybe not, maybe I'm wrong, but I feel like most people know what the limitations to battery stuff is, and me having to, in a 40-second video, to point out every time, because it doesn't matter what bit of equipment it is. If it's battery, you got people going, blah, 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 blah.
That's all right. I mean, we'll create like one of those links and just like put it in the video where it goes, like for complaints about battery gear,
link
click
in
here,
bio,
send
refer
them through.
To this video before watching this video.
That's it.
Catch is pretty good too.
Okay. And it does the whole mulching, catching and...
Yeah, it's got a... mulching plug.
Mm-hmm.
Also has a rear discharge chute. But wow, that's, you can feel those vibrations.
It's busy today at Store Hub for a Sunday.
Very busy. It's, yeah, the rear discharge flap to me goes the wrong way. It throws it.
Okay.
So
normally it goes to the right, to your right as you're pushing it, right?
Well, I think it goes to, yeah, your right as you're pushing it. But to me, then the grass is doing an S because it's being thrown out. You know, normally your grass will go that way. If you're pushing a mower from behind, mm-hmm. it'll, mm-hmm. and you're walking beside it with the flap open, it'll throw out the clippings to your left side. Okay. And I can walk beside it on the right side and not get collected. But from memory, because I used this mower about a year or a year and a half ago and tried that re-discharge plug, shoot, and it went to the right. Mm-hmm. And I'm thinking, okay, so it goes that way, then that way, and I clogged it up super easy.
Okay,
and I'm thinking, why is there might be a technical reason why they've done it that way, but to me it seemed like it was changing the direction of the grass midway, creating...
Yeah, another spot for it to clog up at.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And then if you're using that rear discharge chute, it's probably heavy stuff anyway, so you really don't want it to...
clog up.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So that's the Makita mower. I'm going to use it some more, obviously. Need to give you a turn of it. I think you'll like it.
The Makita, yeah. Looks good. Looks like really
goes
functional.
Goes lower as well than a lot of them. I'd say, you know, 20 mil. Still not quite.
That's okay for battery. I mean, yeah.
Well, yeah. Again, I think 15 is a good number.
Well, the only one I've seen that actually truly goes what qualifies as low has been that 60-volt Massport you tried. Yeah,
it's been that long. I kind of want to give it another go because it's you forget after trying so many different things. Yeah, so we had that. I've been using that. Had bucket loads arrived. The new Mowrator,
mm-hmm.
the all-wheel drive one, which I haven't even had a chance to open the box.
What a difference, eh? The last time it came in, remember? You were like...
I am actually super keen to open it. It's the novelty hasn't worn off. I just haven't had a chance. I've been that flat out. Plus, because listen to everything else that arrived. Had the... I picked up the Steel stuff. Steel's still had some stuff to try there. I think it's an RMA 510, their battery mower, which is the 21-inch AP series batteries. AP's their like professional range of batteries. It's if you've seen the Greenworks, it's very similar chassis.
Some
may even say the same.
Same. Okay.
As that. Well, there you go. You can have a look at that. Motors are obviously different. 36-volt system.
Yeah.
That's a $700 skin only. So that's arrived. Again, haven't had a chance to play with that. They also sent the FSA 90R, which is their, again, same AP series batteries. But not their top end trimmer.
Yep.
This is, they say it's for gardening and maintenance professionals, but they've got one above it, which is the, I can't think now. There are so many people coming in and out of here, aren't there?
Very busy today.
They've got the other one, which I have the multi-tool for. I don't have the straight shaft trimmer.
Okay.
Just because they didn't have stock at the time. But yeah, so we've got the FSA 90R, which is a $649 skin trimmer. It's got the motor in the head.
I can see that. Yeah, I was about to say it. Yeah. It looks like it's got the motor in the head.
AP series batteries. I've actually owned one of these units before.
Mm-hmm.
And the head has changed since I...
had it.
Yeah. They've got Steel's version of the speed feed.
Okay.
On it, which again you may have seen in the line trimmer video that I did the other day. I loaded that. No, you're not watching the stuff.
Oh man, I haven't been on
you're disengaged
socials all that much, to be honest. Like I said,
hey, it's your job. And then finally, they sent out the I don't want to get the model number wrong the GTA 26 cordless chainsaw, the little baby one, the garden pruner, which. I think they said in their email is their number one selling product.
Jeez, okay. Yeah,
which I guess at the price that it's at, I'm looking at prices now, they're a bit all over the shop. Anywhere from tool only $199, maybe $299 with a kit, not sure, skin, but yeah. So we got that to try as well. Then they came with AP500S batteries, which I have I've had steel stuff for a while. Have you used my hedger? My steel hedger?
I don't believe you borrowed
one once, didn't you? A hedger?
No, I was meant to. I didn't, and then I borrowed the Keptec pruners instead.
Oh, no. Didn't I give you the AEG?
No.
Leave that out the front?
Just a string trimmer.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, anyway. Just a multi. Yeah.
Well, I've had the... Can't think of the model number. I think it's HLA65, which has been superseded since then.
Yeah.
Their articulating arm hedge trimmer. I've had that for maybe 7 years or something.
Like, okay.
And it was the first commercial grade battery item that I bought that opened my eyes to the... I'm like, wow, battery stuff is actually not too bad.
Yeah.
Which makes me realise now, you look at their range, that line trimmer that they sent me, that's been out for quite a few years, that model. Maybe there's some minor changes or whatever. This has had an update, this hedge trimmer as well. But I feel like still we're so far ahead of everyone else.
Yep.
Like 5, 6, 7 years ago. I feel like everyone's sort of caught up now.
Yeah, and I think it might be like where steel's kind of primarily in the commercial world. They don't worry too much about the domestic market at all, right? With a lot of the other brands, I feel like they spread thin in terms of trying to target both the audience, trying to capture both the markets as well. I mean, Ego, maybe them as well.
I don't think you're 100% right there saying that they're just... Like, if you look at their range, they've got from entry level.
Yeah.
It's premium entry level, premium pricing entry level.
Yeah.
They've got AK system, which is different battery system, which is aimed at... Home users,
okay.
And then this AP stuff is
I don't know. I seem to, like, since I got into lawn care anyway, only ever associated them with the commercial stuff, like, you know, heavy duty and really serious bit of gear. Yeah.
Well, because you see so many contractors using
steel. I think it's just, like I said, not based in facts, as with most of my opinions.
Yeah.
It's just opinions.
Hey, I can relate to that.
Yeah.
Let me tell you. But yeah, as I said, it's not an insult. It's like, but I look back to, trying that hedge trimmer, and I was just like, I'd used 18-volt little baby ones on my hedges at home. I had some high lily pillies I used to do. Then I got this tool, and I was just like, wow. Like, this thing, it's like, okay, there's value in spending good money on better stuff.
Yep.
Really makes a difference there. But, yeah, I don't feel like I just feel like everyone else is caught up a lot.
Yeah.
Not questioning the quality of them.
Which is always good for the end user in the end. Yeah. More competitors there are.
What I was saying about the batteries, when I bought them years ago, and I had the blower as well, their handheld blower, I had the AP300 batteries, which were the biggest at the time. They've now got an AP300S, which is bigger again, and then an AP500S.
Okay.
Bigger again. Same form factor though, completely the same form factor, but might be about a third bigger or something. They are not cheap though. I just looked at the pricing on them.
Okay.
$649 for a battery.
Nice.
So lots of steel stuff arrive. We'll talk about that at some point. We also had the Ego stuff arrive, which we'll talk about shortly. The one that isn't here, which we won't talk about today, the Ego Commercial Edger. Tool only. So it's a dedicated stick edger.
Got it.
I'm super keen to try that out.
It's not even a multi-attachment, eh? It's a standalone dedicated
stick edger.
Cool.
So very keen to try that. And then we might just switch to the other microphones and do a dynamic sort of look at these, the differences between the old Ego Multi and the new Ego Multi.
Yeah. Remember that, I guess it's not just video format, right? It's the part of...
Okay, so Karthik is holding the brand new Ego Multi-Tool.
Good-looking unit, isn't it?
It is. The model number is PH1420E, which has superseded the old 1400E, I believe, PH1400E? PH1400E. Similar... but different in a lot of ways. I'll get to that head in a second. That head is all new as well. Only reason I have the power rotary scissors on this is because I've been using it for that.
Because they've got their own, obviously.
Yes, I just wanted to try mine because I just sharpened them.
Yeah.
That's an aftermarket part. So if you just pass that to me now, thank you, Karthik.
Like that.
Obvious differences, anything you can see?
Oh, it looks completely different, doesn't it? The top end looks completely different in terms of design itself.
I'd say it's similar but different.
Yeah. I mean, like where the battery slots in, everything else like that is pretty similar. There's no change, just the look of it overall.
Bit more rubber on the top part, where you would rest your forearm. And around just the controls in general.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know if that aids in, you know, vibration. Probably you're not feeling it through your forearm.
Plus, I guess, if you're chucking it down on the floor and stuff like that, an extra bit to absorb bumps.
Yeah, battery feeds in exactly the same way. Mm-hmm. I can't speak to the specs because I couldn't quickly find anything today on it. It'd be good to find easy specs.
Power Plus.
Same thing. That's mm-hmm. It is called Ego Power Plus. Yep. But the biggest differences, I will point out, the throttle, the trigger on this is so much improved from the original one. We've had many conversations about
triggers,
triggers and, you know, finger fatigue. The older model has a very, you can feel it there. It's a
feels
like a heavy trigger.
Day and night difference. That was just such a soft...
Whereas
response as well on that one.
The new one has a very light one, and the safety is built into it.
Yeah.
So it's,
what do you think of the safety there? Which
Karthik's like talking about the safety on the old one, which if you put your hand around the handle on your thumb basically depresses the safety on that, and then your other fingers control the throttle.
Yeah. Just
whereas this one, it's one finger. You just push under the trigger,
mm-hmm.
one finger, and then you pull it away. So it's one less step almost.
Okay, you think, okay.
I didn't mind that one, but again,
yeah, I was going to say, it feels pretty natural here as well.
I didn't mind it. I know a lot of people weren't massive on it. Mm-hmm. I think this is better, especially once you've been using it for a while, because you just slide that finger
as you're holding
up that trigger and pull it.
Yep.
So trigger, very much improved. That's the thing that I like about this the most, and the thing that would make me buy this.
Yep, is the trigger.
Yeah, and that much that I would pay the extra $150 because they're probably running this out now or whatever. I've seen them as low as maybe $250 for the skin only alone.
Okay.
I think the skin only alone for the new one is $400, $399.
Right. Yep. But I know you're big. I mean, when you use them for extended periods as well. Yeah, so it makes a big difference for you.
But it's just, it feels like you've got more control with this trigger.
Yeah. You know? But I guess if you're a homeowner, it's a good bargain if they're running these out.
Yeah.
Because it was a really good unit.
Still. Yeah, I think I saw Sydney Tools have got 34%
off. Yeah. Because, I mean, you get one of these, you're probably set for like, for a long time. You don't need to
in
buy
theory,
a replacement.
Yeah. The other thing with it is the speed adjustment. So the old one has a switch.
One and two.
One and two speed. The new one has a button and two LED lights.
Okay.
So you just push that in and out, and one light is obviously
more digital.
Single speed.
Yep.
Two lights is high speed.
Mm-hmm.
Again, works. Hopefully it, you know. My only issue with these sorts of buttons, see how it's a rubberized button? You ever notice how you use them a lot and they again, this is a...
The attachment looks slightly different in shape.
Let me get there, Karthik. You're getting ahead of yourself. Another person here. This is... It's like Pitt Street at the moment. So I do like it.
Mm-hmm.
Where were we going? You threw me off.
No, you were working your way down the machine.
Working my way down.
So you're done with throttle, done with the speed adjustment.
Handlebar, the D handle. Feels very similar,
mm-hmm.
looks very similar. The only difference being that it's got a quick release on it.
Is a quick release more to adjust position?
For adjustment, yeah. So it's got a quick release. You just pull that up and then you can slide it up or down.
Yeah.
What I have found though,
slips.
It just doesn't feel like a great quick release to me. It doesn't feel, because I can still, I've done it up quite tight and I can still rotate it around if I want to.
Which is probably because of the quick release function, isn't it?
Yeah. And then I'm like, I don't want to do it up too tight because the wing nut is plastic and then it's got the nut part is metal, but that's like, I don't want to overdo it and
I see what
break
you mean.
It.
So. This one was more of a permanent setup. You find your position, lock it in and it's not going
to budge. Yeah. It has a kickback bar integrated into that, which you have to have on to tighten it up enough.
Okay.
I can't stand, especially on a domestic unit.
Yeah.
So a kickback bar, if you're listening and don't know what I'm talking about, it's a bar that sticks out perpendicular to the shaft
around
your thigh. in case you get some kickback and it stops it coming back at you, essentially.
Okay.
I will be hacking that straight off because it just gets in the way. It's for me. You can actually see I've done that on the other one there.
Oh, really? Okay. Yeah. Oh, yeah. I do see that now. Yeah.
The handle feels very similar.
Mm-hmm.
The attachment, what do we call this, Karthik?
Attachment. Oh, sorry.
What, the attachment point. Yeah, where you connect up the attachments.
It's got one
is
of
it
the
identical?
Better. It's it got looks... one of the better. Oh, just the shape looks slightly different. This you one's think? More circular. That one's got that little...
Well, not so much that part of it. I'm more talking...
Nah, otherwise I think it looks identical.
Yeah, so the actual connection part of it is...
Yeah.
There's a little spindle,
it's one of the
release.
One of the smoother ones I've seen as well. It goes in and out really
works
easy.
Very well. We have tried one recently that's not quite like that. Yeah. It works a little bit different in that... You're saying the new one's a little bit thicker around the shaft there. I think because it has to deliver power for one of these, which I'll get to in a second.
Mm.
We skipped over the fact that it's got a carbon fiber shaft.
Well,
the old one's
really
steel.
Skip over it? We got to it just in time.
Yeah. Carbon fiber shaft. Then we go to the attachment. The only new attachment that I have with it, I didn't need any other attachments because all the old attachments fit on the new model.
Which is good. Yeah.
All the... new attachments fit on the old one as well, besides the one that I have here, which is, and we kind of spoke about this last week, this is the power load line mm-hmm. trimmer head. So it's a shaft line trimmer attachment. The unique part about it is it's got a motor that will rewind the line itself.
Automatically, so, yep.
Yeah, I'd have to pull it out to show you
So does it wind it, if you keep the button down, does it know to stop when it starts getting to the correct length, or does it just keep going?
I feel like it would just keep going in. Let's do it now, just to do it anyway.
You sure? You're okay. Yeah, okay.
There we go. It keeps going in. So you got to stop right before you do it. It's a bump feed head. I'll pull the line out and show you how it works, actually.
I'll put this down.
So we've taken the line out now. We are going to demo the power load feature. It's annoying to take the line out, I will say that.
So you don't want to really snap it off, do you?
Don't snap it off in the head because it's going to be annoying.
Yeah.
So you should be able to just poke it through the eyelet there, pop out the other side. Karthik's going for a spin. Grab those two sides, Karthik. Get those even for me if you can. I do this every time.
Mm-hmm.
Karthik's just dropped it, made us look like amateurs, but I do it every time.
We are amateurs.
Correct. try and get it
close
exactly
enough.
Even.
Oh, well, okay.
You want to try and get it spot on because... It's yep. going to be uneven okay. at the end. And then, yeah, you can let it go now. We just press, there's a button down the bottom.
Is it on camera?
Yep, there's a button down the bottom just above the safety guard. You just push that. I don't know if you can hear it ratcheting, but it's just ratcheting up. It's quick enough.
That's cool.
Yeah. I mean, it's an awesome feature. There you go. So that's rewound perfectly now. It's a bump feed head.
Can I, while you're on the head,
yeah.
is the head flatter than it used to be before? I can't remember what the old one looked like, but did it have like a, I feel like the clearance from the ground to the where the string is was more than this before on Eagles?
I can't remember, to be honest with you. I didn't use that head for very long. I will be straight with you.
Yeah, that one's all right too, yeah, sorry.
Which one?
No, the one you've got.
The
on
new
the
one, yeah, it's similar. Oh, no, it's a bit different, actually.
That's a bit flatter, too.
Talking garbage.
Yeah.
The guard isn't too obtrusive, in my opinion. What do you think?
No, it's okay. It's one for a domestic unit again, because usually they stick really big ones on.
Yeah.
That is not a problem. That is where... Yeah. It's all right. Look, I would still be taking it off, but
would
that's
you?
Just me. I'm not the smartest one. You've met me before. yeah, but I see what you mean. I'd struggle with the vertical still on this. I just wish they made one, like some brands have them, just the hat.
Yeah, the best one I've seen. Who was that recently?
Oh,
the Greenworks is the smallest that I've seen. The least obtrusive. I don't know what you're...
The 80-volt one, yeah.
Yeah, the 82-volt. This is... that's very small.
Oh, no. Like I just said, I didn't blame the tool. I just said, I'm like the issue, not the guard.
Yeah.
I didn't say the guard was the issue. I said I was the issue.
Again, I can't speak to the... power difference. I've had a quick go. The only go I've had is with my power rotary scissors this afternoon, and it was enjoyable to use.
So you're telling me that won't slot into this power unit, though?
So, yes,
that's the only
this new power load
head will not fit on the
old multi-head.
Yeah, and the reason for that, if you take this off here, undo that spindle, see how, this is my assumption anyway.
Mm-hmm.
Obviously it needs power delivered to the head yep. to power the motor to re-spool it. And it looks like there's two nipples there
yeah.
that are the contacts for the power.
Got it, okay.
So they obviously make contact there, but that would prevent it going into
this
the
shaft.
Older model.
Yep.
Yeah,
that makes sense.
So for me, I think it's awesome tech. I think it's really cool. It yeah. looks awesome, but for me, I would just prefer the standard.
They give you the option, the obviously. Like,
well, this was in a kit. This came in a kit, so you can buy it like this. I think it was $529 or $549. I did put it somewhere.
Mm-hmm. I think a lot of homeowners will like the tech, though.
Yeah.
I think that a lot of homeowners will find it useful.
Yeah. For me, it's just another thing to go wrong,
yeah.
potentially.
Yeah.
It's a 40-centimeter line, which is very decent for a homeowner machine.
Yep.
So overall, I like it. Haven't had a chance in terms of feel. And trigger. Mm-hmm. I feel it's just going to operate the same as the other one. You can put your blade edger on it, you can put your hedge trimmer, the roto cut attachment, whatever you want to put on it. But
yeah,
that's the new Ego Multi. I will make a full video on it. I will take it out in the wild and show you guys. One thing I did notice though, mm-hmm. on the shaft, it actually says, there's a sticker saying, when utilizing the power load function after prolonged line trimming, the power load system may stop working due to over temperature protection. So,
okay.
So it sounds like if you've been using it in heavy stuff for a while, it may not work right away till it cools down, which
that's the moment you want
like
it to work.
Yeah. Quite a limitation, but then again, if
I think
it is
just covering themselves.
If it is in a residential situation, you're probably not going to be using it in
extended, yeah.
My advice would be, if you are going to be heavy using it, probably not the tool for you. If it's just around the house and it's maintenance,
mm-hmm.
I think it's going to be, you know, awesome for you.
Yeah.
Yeah. All right.
Good looking unit.
Let's go sit down, Karthik.
Back to sitting.
So that's Ego's new multi-tool. Like I said, I'll have more on that. Apologies if that didn't translate audio-wise. We are very new to this. The last thing I'll talk about before we go,
mm-hmm.
or two things actually. Had some new line trimmer line.
I saw that video.
Did you?
Yeah, I saw. What did it taste like? Yeah,
it
there you go.
It doesn't taste, yeah. Do you think, have a feel of that. Do you think it feels rubbery or? To me, I
just a small, skinny one, yeah?
That's just the 2.4. Now, this brand is Izuma. It's meant to be Japanese made. I don't know where you can get it yet. I don't know if they've released it. They haven't even told me.
It does feel less plastic, more rubbery, doesn't it?
It doesn't,
still plastic. But
yeah, but it doesn't feel...
a bit more flex on it.
Brittle?
Yeah, a bit more flex on it.
Maybe.
Feels like it's already been soaked in water and tomato ketchup.
Yes, yeah. It feels... doesn't feel dehydrated, does
yeah.
it?
Yeah.
Again, we're not being paid to show this or anything, but they just...
So what? They're a Japanese brand, is it?
Yeah. I mean, there's an importer here that's importing it,
mm-hmm.
but apparently this is Japanese premium grade reinforced lined Izuma. I've got it in 2.4, 2.75 and 3.3, I believe.
Okay.
So I'm going to be using this exclusively for the next couple of weeks just to see how it goes.
Goes, yeah.
As I've always said, I think the line choice is the...
it's immaterial in the end.
Yeah, as long as you're not going the cheapest, nastiest stuff.
Yeah.
I think as long as your technique's right.
I got a couple of spools of that laying at home still.
The cheapest
nasty stuff, yeah. I think one was from, I don't name brands, but it wasn't, it wasn't a manufacturer that would normally be making it.
Yeah.
So it's just, yeah, it's a shopping center you'd go through and buy groceries and find deals at, yeah.
Yeah, I found the only time I've had trouble is just because I didn't know what I was doing.
Yeah, yeah.
Once you know how to use it, as in using
I feel like such a pro now when I'm not like breaking it off every other minute. I get through the whole thing I've fed into the line trimmer.
Yeah.
And every time it runs out, I feel so proud that I haven't had to halfway through stop and like take the whole thing apart because I broke it off and yeah.
So I don't know much on this. I'll get some more information on it, cost and where you buy it, if it's any good.
You're going to stock it yourself? No.
Okay. Oh God, I don't need any more things to do. Please.
Run around shipping it.
I don't know. I'll give anything a try, though. I got really excited when they contacted me. I thought they contacted me saying we've got Japanese trimmer line to try out. And then I thought it was just like
poor English someone in Japan with
a... Oh, they're going to send you a string trimmer itself?
Yeah, I thought it was a line trimmer, Japanese...
Whoa.
Oh, Karthik's throwing the microphone away. I thought it was a Japanese line trimmer.
Got
a new
it,
one.
Got
and
it.
I got really excited. I'm like, oh, cool. I haven't heard of this.
Yeah,
and
yeah, yeah.
I'm Googling it, couldn't find it. But, you know, it turned out to be trimmer line.
So when it turned up in a little box, you kind of went, how did they fit it in there?
Yeah. What have you seen this week, Karthik?
Look, I saw the one, I think it was in Coffs Harbour. I sent it to you and I thought, it's one of those topics that people always have divisive opinions on. I got plenty of it when I used to look after my patch out the front of the house.
Yep.
It's the whole argument of council strip. Owners who look after it and then get hurt when it gets damaged by someone. And then the other opinion, which is, it's a council strip. You shouldn't be bothering with it in the first place anyway. I see both sides' point. But
what happened in the video?
Somebody, I think it was at Coffs Harbour.
I think we should make this a segment. What did Karthik see on the internet this week?
Just what did Karthik see segment. Yeah, yep. No, it was someone at Coffs Harbour.
Yep.
Who... I think he put a video out on socials himself.
Yeah.
But then obviously the video blew up because people got opinions on the topic where he had put a bin and then got like a temporary fencing.
So he blocked off his
council strip.
And the video. Pathway?
And in the video.
Was it just grass?
Well, the postie could still access the mailbox from the driveway. But after he wouldn't be able to walk across the grass to get to the next house.
But there wasn't a footpath there?
There wasn't a footpath there.
So someone looking after
the council strip.
The council's land.
Yeah.
And blocking it off. And did the postie...
Because the postie had walked on it and left like really bad footprints after the big rains we got, I believe.
Yeah.
So he blocked it off and then posted that video.
And
obviously
blasted.
The comments went off. Obviously the comments went off.
It's always a good one.
Yeah, it just brought back memories of when I used to have a council strip and people thought I was super protective of it at the time. And I played along to that, obviously. Played along like I really, really didn't want anyone touching it. But you've seen the reality of what that council strip was. Kids played on it, didn't matter. I wasn't too protective of it. But people that think that you should not care about it at all because it's a council strip, I have never seen the point of that.
Like, no, I don't.
It's in front of your house.
But you've invested time into it too.
And you've seen what our councils do in terms of looking after it. Yeah, they don't turn up.
No.
Basically, they don't turn up. Like mine wasn't.
I don't expect them to though. I always see that, you're doing the council's job. It's like, it's out the front of your house.
Yeah, but
I'm
talking about the person that comments to go, why would you even look after it at all?
Yeah.
Right? Like I built my house and that council strip had no turf on it. It was just a mound of dirt for almost a year and a half because I couldn't afford to turf it yet. Council was not going to turn up and get rid of that mound of dirt and then put turf down. So if I'd left it there, it would still be a mound of dirt to this day.
Exactly.
Or I'd have got a letter from the council that said, it's in front of your property. You need to maintain it.
I don't know. I don't think that you would get anything about it.
Yeah. So, I mean, eventually I kind of went, okay, I'm going to turf it. Yeah. And that got me into turf care. But then given I'd put the effort into turf it, I wanted to look after it. It was in front of my house.
Yeah.
I knew it was council land. I knew they had all rights on it. But I don't see why people get so angry that others put effort in to look after what's in front of their own house. That's just where I stand. I get what they're talking about.
Yeah.
If I inherited a crap-looking one, I then put the effort in to make it look nice because it's in front of my house.
Yeah.
I care. I'm not saying fire the postie. I get it. The postie has to do his job. And that's fine. But I'm allowed to feel bad when someone destroys it, though.
So why do you hate posties?
I do not. I actually really get along with my postie. She's been lovely. She was heartbroken when they decided to put the footpath through my lawn.
Yeah.
Yeah. Even though it's like good for her, I get along with my postie. No problems at all.
No, it's a very common one. Anytime you see someone complaining post, I mean, you're not hiding to nothing if you're complaining about someone going over your nature strip.
Yep.
And I understand why, because I know how much effort goes into it. But you just, if you post it on social media for everyone to see, and most people just aren't fanatical like us about their lawns, they're just not going to understand. You're on a hiding to nothing.
You watch this video now. I wonder what the comments are going to be like, right?
The other one...
You had something, didn't you?
Yeah, maybe we'll call it what Tim saw on the internet this week.
What Tim saw,
Did you see... Had you seen this before I sent it to you? The plover bird. Have you seen the video?
No, my God. I just remembered what you'd sent me.
Yeah.
I'd forgotten about it for a second. No, I had not seen it. And that kind of got me as well when I watched that.
Again, you may or may not have seen it, but there was a lawn guy, I guess you'd call him. He was a hired lawn person,
mm-hmm.
and there's security camera footage of him taking his line trimmer to a plover bird to the point where it is no longer alive.
Yeah, yeah.
I don't know why.
And then he proceeds to, like, I think, yeah, they dispose of the what's left of it into the bin, and then they find the nest and get rid of the eggs as well. And it just,
yeah.
I kept reading the article going, oh my God, what is going on here? And apparently the owner had, from the article, owner had actually told him there's a, like, the bird there, the nest there, they just come every year, leave them alone. So I don't know where he
if
was coming from.
If you've got no experience with plover birds, they can be a little bit annoying in that they get very protective.
Are they like the Indian miners that are hated here as well? No, I'm just saying, because they're not local, right?
Why are you
going to
make it about race, Karthi?
That's what the bird's name is.
When they're nesting,
yeah,
they will swoop.
Ah,
we used to have them on the oval at
but magpies are like everyone's favourite, even though they do it too. We laugh about
it. Well, it's very much like
the same thing.
They're very protective of their nest. But I don't know how you get to that point where you could... I just couldn't
take a whippersnipper to it, yeah. It seems a bit extreme.
Yeah.
Yeah. Apparently, because I know that he worked for like a company and the owner has said he's been let go off or disciplined or something along those lines and stuff.
Yeah, but I mean, what sort of headspace are you in to...
Do that to a bird?
Yeah.
I don't know. There's got to be more going on there to that story maybe, but...
Yeah.
Anyway, it was messed up. It just... I kind of had to... Yeah.
Unfortunate that the industry in any way gets shown in that... light.
Yeah, more men are the best in the world. Why would you go doing that, eh?
Yeah. Well, that's I didn't see much else. I saw some other stuff.
Oh, there's plenty. I was watching a whole lot about the golf course. I forget. The Augusta, I think. It's been a lot of really nice content.
The Masters, yeah.
Yeah, but like there's been some really good, well-produced content out there for it. But
which one did you like? What was it? I saw one this morning that I'm like, oh, wow, that's cool.
Oh, no, I was seeing, I think there was a... It was being discussed on someone else's podcast, if I'm not wrong, and I cannot remember whose it was, but they were talking about the image of like about 8 triplex cylinder mowers on the fairway, side by side, mowing the whole...
Staggered.
Yeah. It always blows me away when I look at that, obviously. Yeah, not every golf course has...
It's just a beautiful place, hey? I think I read somewhere they cut the greens at 3 mil.
Oh, could very well be.
I believe I read it. No. I did see a short video this morning. They replace... The divots. So when you,
I know enough. I know the terminology.
So
mostly,
you take your swing and you take chunk out of the ground. They've got you've got your plugger at home.
Yep.
Which is a circle. They've got more of an oval one, which is basically the shape of a divot.
Right.
And every day,
they replace every single
divot.
Yeah,
like at most golf courses, they just sand over them.
Correct.
And then just wait for the grass to grow back through.
Correct.
But they every day they replace every.
Is that for the Masters only, or do they do that all year round? Like just...
Oh, I can't say for sure. Okay. I imagine probably for the
Masters.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. It's the flagship. TV, it's their big day out in the sun, right?
But on the tee boxes, just replacing every...
Yeah, divot.
Yeah.
It is an amazing, amazing
course.
It's
just so peaceful to have on in the background watching, even if you're not into golf, I think. I did hear, though, that the broadcaster plays... birds and nature sounds, which you can probably hear here. It's very in the alarm.
I was going to say it's a burglar alarm.
To make
alarm.
It sound a little bit more
welcoming, naturey.
Yeah.
Okay.
I did hear that. I'd love to get over there someday. But
golfing skills. I've hardly even done it. But just golf courses.
I'd love to walk the place and see what it's like.
Yeah.
I do wonder if they paint it. It's too consistent green for me to.
I don't know. I wouldn't be surprised if they don't, to be honest, with the skills they'd have on site, but I wouldn't be shocked if they do.
Yeah. Because in the end, there's many skills. How are you guys? Is there a toilet here?
Yeah.
Are you a store? Yeah, if you just put your code in there and then go around, there's a toilet in there. You're all right. No worries. We're just doing a podcast. That's all right,
guys.
That's all right. We're not even meant to be here.
Oh.
Don't tell anyone.
What are you talking about?
I don't know. Like, you can have as many skills as you like, but it's just to be that uniformly green.
Yeah, but I mean, I'll guarantee you, speak to the greenskeeper at Augusta, he's not going to have a problem with lawn paint when it's used in the correct scenarios either. And that's what I mean about, like, there's a place for it, right?
Yeah, definitely.
Yeah. I think they went the wrong way, but that's all right. It's not
all
my
right.
problem.
Well, that's probably all I got for this week. hopefully
what everyone, have we got another hour anyway, yeah?
Yeah, hopefully everyone has a lovely week. Congratulations to the winners of the prizes. Make sure you send me an email, timthelawnmowerman@gmail.com.
Have a good week, everyone.
Until next week, goodbye.
See ya.